Hey all, don't forget to subscribe and click that notification button so you don't miss a thing. Also, come follow us on social media at Disney Food Blog. Hey everybody, it's AJ for Disney Food Blog, and today we are going to compare a couple of restaurants that we get asked a lot about. We are going over to Disney's Hollywood Studios, and we're going to go to 50s Primetime Cafe and Sci-Fi Dine-In Theater. These are two restaurants that are full of Disney Imagineering. They're two of my favorite restaurants in Hollywood Studios, and they're very similar when it comes to the fact that you've got an extremely themed restaurant, you've got moderately priced comfort food, and relatively high appeal to families visiting Walt Disney World. So these are very similar restaurants in those respects, and we get asked a lot, which one should I choose? So we are going to go over the atmosphere, the service and experience at both restaurants, and then the food at both restaurants to try to help you decide which one is right for you and your family. Let's get started. Okay, we're going to start with atmosphere, and we're going to go to 50s Primetime Cafe first. So 50s Primetime Cafe is over there near Echo Lake in Hollywood Studios. This is a 1950s retro restaurant, and the theme here is that you are eating in mom's kitchen, and the servers are basically your cousins or your aunts and uncles sometimes, but they're your family members who are bringing you your food from mom's kitchen, and mom is in the kitchen. The restaurant itself almost looks like a 1950s set from a sitcom. The ceiling is all black, and then you have all of these different sort of little kitchen dining rooms to sit in that are all themed a little bit differently, but they're all from the 1950s. You might see knickknacks there that your mom or your grandmother had when you were a kid. This is all authentic stuff. I'm sure they got all this stuff at yard sales and estate sales and things like that. You've got very mid-century tabletops and wallpaper, color, light fixtures, things like that are all very 1950s. Now, several of the tables at 50s Primetime are called, well, I call them TV tables, quote unquote. And these actually have televisions set up right next to them so that you can watch TV. Now, there are also some televisions hanging up in the corners, so everyone at every table can see a television. But some of those TV tables have a TV right there. I always like to request those. Those are my favorite, of course. And on the TV are old clips of shows like Donna Reed and the Mickey Mouse Club, things like that that maybe you and I watched on Nick at Night when we were kids, or our parents watched when they were growing up. So it's a very cool and very fun atmosphere going on. Now the service and experience that you're going to have here, the service is usually very good in my experience. A lot of the servers have been here for many years. They're very good at their jobs and they're efficient and they deliver. Disney restaurants do tend to have a general feel of, you know, get them in, get them out, because they want to turn those tables over and make more money. And I think that the servers here know that and they're pretty good at it. I don't ever feel rushed when I'm there, but I certainly don't feel like I'm sitting there and waiting for my food a long time. The experience here is going to be different from 50s Primetime in that this restaurant encourages the staff and the servers to be a little irreverent and sort of treat you like you are a kid at home in your mom's kitchen. And if you don't eat your vegetables or you don't wash your hands after you go to the bathroom, you may end up singing I'm a Little Teapot in front of the whole restaurant, or going to stand in the corner. You might get your vegetables from your dinner brought back to you for dessert with a bunch of whipped cream on top. So there's lots of funny things that they do and fun things that they do. And again, it's irreverent, it's fun antics, and I will guarantee you that your kids will think it's hilarious if you get sent to stand in the corner. But just know, if you're there and you'd rather not take part in all of that, just let your server know, hey, I just want to watch today. I don't really want to be a part of the show. And they're fine with that, and they'll be perfectly comfortable with that, and will sort of keep you out of the show in that case. But it is really fun, especially if you have a large family there, to sort of play along, and the kids will just laugh hysterically at you. So be prepared for that. So that's the general service and experience of 50s Primetime. Now going on to the food. The food at 50s Primetime is classic comfort food. We're talking onion rings, chicken noodle soup, pork chops, chicken pot pie, meatloaf, pot roast, stuff like that. These are always on the menu. One of my favorite meals here is Aunt Liz's fried chicken. I tell you guys that all the time. And now, just a couple years ago, they actually introduced a sampler platter where you can try the pot roast, the fried chicken, and the meatloaf, which are the three top sellers. You can try them all on one plate. So it's kind of like a sampler platter, basically, where you get a small portion of each of their top three favorites. So that's really cool. And of course, the menu changes a little bit every once in a while. You'll get a variety of vegetarian dishes. You've got market priced salmon right now. And then there's a blue plate special on the menu right now that they call, quote unquote, a healthy seasonal alternative with all the fixings, which is market priced. So I don't know what that means. I'll have to try it out next time I'm there. Desserts here have been great in the past. Now they're not so great. There's an apple crisp, which is pretty standard, and canned apple and thing like that. There's a chocolate peanut butter layered cake, which is okay. Ice cream sundae cheesecake, mom's brownie, which is basically a brownie sundae. So pretty standard desserts. They're not anything to write home about. If you're on the dining plan, go ahead and get dessert. If not, maybe save that and go get, you know, a Butterfinger cupcake or a carrot cake cookie over at Trolley Car instead. But generally, the food is pretty good. I like it. I think it's a fun experience. I really enjoy going to 50's Primetime. I try to get there as often as I can. Oh, my favorite thing on the menu, of course, is that fried herb and garlic cheese. One of my favorite things. They took it away and they brought it back just a couple of years ago. I'm so glad it's back. It hasn't budged since. So decent menu items, comfort food, picky eaters are very welcome and will be very happy. So that's kind of what you're going to get over there at 50's Primetime. I think the biggest thing that makes this stand out over Sci-Fi is going to be that interactive experience that you have with your server. If you put your elbows on the table or if you don't set the table correctly, you know, you may end up being quote unquote punished. So kind of fun little experience, and that's what you have at 50's Primetime. Now over to Sci-Fi Dine-In Theater Restaurant. So this is an interesting restaurant in that you are sitting in a convertible car, basically. Many of the tables, I would say the majority of the tables, are in convertible cars, and you are supposed to be at a big, huge drive-in theater. Now it's all indoors, but they have imagineered it so it looks and feels like you're outside of a drive-in theater, again in the 1950s. So it's that same time frame that's being represented. So it's very dark in here. Again, it's supposed to be nighttime, and behind you, the kitchen is mocked up to look like a refreshment stand at a drive-in theater. The screen in front of you is showing little clips of sort of B-movies, you know, the Attack of the 50-Foot Woman and Swamp Thing and all those funny films from the 50s, which might actually be a little bit scary for little ones. So think about that ahead of time. You know, watch some clips on YouTube of what the movies look like and just make sure your little ones are going to be okay with that. But usually they're so excited to sit in a car that they're just having a blast sitting in this, you know, convertible car eating their food that they don't care what's on the screen. But that's kind of what goes on there. The film roll is pretty quick. I think it's maybe only 30 minutes or less. So you're probably going to end up seeing the same things a couple of times if you're there a little bit longer than expected. Service here is going to be very similar to what you have at 50's Primetime as far as efficiency. Many have been serving there for quite some time. They're very good at their jobs. So I've never really had a huge problem with service at Sci-Fi Dine-In. The experience is going to be a little bit different in that you're not going to have that interactive nature that you do over at 50's Primetime because you're watching movies. All right, let's head over to the food. The food at this restaurant, again, is going to be very accessible. Major comfort food, chicken tenders, fried pickles, onion rings again, lots of burgers, steaks, pastas, ribs, turkey sandwiches. There's a barbecue platter right now. So pretty standard stuff. Same kind of things you're going to get at your favorite chain restaurant at home. Every once in a while, it looks like Sci-Fi's menu is going to take a leap up and be a little bit better, but it always tends to be sort of mediocre. I would say 50's Primetime has better food than Sci-Fi does on the regular, but some of the items are quite good. And so just a heads up, you know, you're not going to have bad food at Sci-Fi. It's not going to wow anybody. Desserts here are a little bit more fun. You've got a house-made Sci-Fi candy bar, which is basically, you know, candy bars were a big trend a couple of years ago. It's basically just a rectangular cake. It's almost like an opera cake, but they dunked it in chocolate. They have a s'mores brownie and ice cream. They have a warmed glazed donut sundae here, which isn't as good as it sounds, so you know. They've got a lemon cheesecake, fresh fruit salad, hot fudge sundae. So pretty standard stuff for dessert too. Again, I'd probably skip it and go get something from Trolley Car instead. So food is going to be very similar at both restaurants in terms of quality and the type of food that you're eating. So that's kind of the comparison there. So the thing, again, that makes Sci-Fi stand out is that you are eating in a convertible car and that you're watching these movies while you're eating. So that's kind of fun. If you do have someone who can't eat in the car or isn't able to, some of the cars are actually sort of stretched out and there's an actual table with chairs placed in between the front and the back of the car. And then there are also picnic tables in the back, and the picnic tables have locations for wheelchairs and high chairs and things like that. So that's a place you want to go if you need a high chair, wheelchair, or something like that. So you still get to watch the screen and everything, but you aren't going to be in a convertible car unless you're in one of those kind of stretched out ones that have a bunch of people seated in the middle. So there's a look at two of my favorite restaurants in Hollywood Studios. And I know it's funny that they're two of my favorite restaurants because I said the food isn't all that great. But honestly, there's not a lot going on in Hollywood Studios. You know, hey, what can I say? Hollywood Brown Derby Lounge is my place of choice at the moment in the studios. We'll see what happens when Star Wars Galaxy's Edge opens. But right now, there's slim pickings for food. But these two are really fun. They're really highly themed. If you want a Disney magic sort of vacation where you're having truly Disney themed and imagineered restaurants, these two are two of the best to try. So I hope that's helpful. Please let me know in the comments what you guys think. What's your favorite of 50s primetime versus sci-fi? Have you been to either? Have you been to both? We'd love to hear your experiences and your comments about the food you liked, your service experience, and your funny antics stories about 50s primetime. We love hearing those stories. So please let us know in the comments all about that. All right, guys, thanks for listening and thanks for watching. This is AJ for Disney Food Blog. And we'll see you real soon.